That's right, Mark's Auto Spirits too hot. Followers, let's introduce Mr. PC Brooms himself.
Bad boys, what you want, what you want, what you gonna do?
Yeah, come on.
Bad boys, bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when I come for you?
What you gonna do? Bad boys, bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do
when I come for you?
Bad boys, bad boys, what you gonna do? Let's introduce your Royal Highness Queen Archibald Cox. You could just say Indian, I'll settle for Indian.
All Indian, darling.
No, just Indian.
All the Barbados, y'all may be seated now. Y'all may be seated. The Queen is in the building.
In the building.
2 half an hour's clubbing months of full PC, bro.
Mark Auto Spears. Four locations to serve you, people. Mm-hmm. Bel Air St. George, you can telephone Bel Air at 437-9819. Spooner Sales St. Michael, 425-9361. Salter St. George, 228-6992. And 6 Road St. Philip, 271-1297. Only top brand air parts for your vehicle. Mark Auto Spears, the number one. Joshy.
One.
Yeah. Auto Spears in Barbados.
All right.
He, if you ain't here, you're going to do work, man.
He echoing working properly. He echoing working properly there.
The number one. Right.
Make yourself
right.
Useful, yeah.
Useful, yeah, but you're not doing nothing.
You're working, all right. Are you signing
up? What are you doing?
Doing what?
But you're doing nothing.
With a cell phone.
We got a phone here that we're fixing.
Let's call out there being a servant.
What, you peeping?
But yeah, I don't know what you're doing.
You're
called out there loitering. You know, in some places, right, the police just come up to your house, what are you doing here?
Yeah, it's true.
I'd ask you to move along.
No. Right, move along.
Yes, sir. What's your reason for standing up here?
Let me ask this question.
Yeah.
If you see police officer, you can ask him, you know what?
You see, you want the tail to wag the dog, right? The tail is not supposed to wag the dog. That's how it is work. A police can call you an idiot. You can't call a police an idiot. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying, right? Why are the police? Neither is you. That's what the law is. The law is work. The police can tell you, listen, you idiot, move that car from there. And from until you call the police, you idiot.
You know what time it's happening.
Yeah, you have government bangles, and next thing you're in court. An idiot calls the police an idiot, and he will spend 30 days per remand, so it is work backwards. Anyhow, we are so compliments to Mark's Auto Spares. Remember, Mark's Auto Spares is the number one place in Barbados for quality car parts. Mm-hmm. Quality service, good parking, good locations, everything, and decent prices. Mm-hmm. Can't do more than oil is still in fact. You can get the fuels, fluids.
Yeah, fluids.
Different fluids, hydraulic fluid, transmission fluid, all the kinds of fluids, oils, you name it. Now, not only those, the small things, also got doors, windows, bumpers, rear lights, front lights, you name it. They have it in at Mark's Auto Spares.
Right.
Go down there and see what's happening in Barbados. Meanwhile, there's a cleanup campaign in Barbados called Clean Beam. I don't know about the PC room.
Yeah, you're about it, yes.
Right. So it's coming to Warren's. I think this weekend.
This weekend, yes.
This weekend. You hear about it then?
I hear about it, yes. I know about it.
So they will be in Warren. Mm-hmm. They're meeting at 6 a.m. In Massey Car Park.
At the Massey Car Park, correct.
That is Super Center Car Park. See everyone
yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. Massey Car Park, they're meeting at 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. I think they're going to do some presentations on community recycling and green waste and different things. Mm-hmm. But they want people to register or call them. Mm-hmm. You got a number there for them or anything?
No, I ain't got your number here, but the meeting at the Massey Car Park at 6 a.m. to do a cleanup from 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. And from 8 a.m. in the same Massey Car Park, 8 to 12, they got lectures on waste management, recycling, health checks, and other activities going to be going on there.
So they're doing the cleaning area?
At Massey, wrong Warren's area. Wrong Massive.
So wait. don't confuse my head though. What do you want to come and clean my city car park for free? There's a threat here. Don't let me be.
No,
let me know.
Got other billions and things wrong.
Massive. So wait. So you been there, my city car park?
Go sleep on it. You know, got cold men. We have little fine cold shells.
Oh, okay. Tell me.
On the highway, anything that can clean.
Also, the highway, anybody where they're bushes and things, they clean up down the area and things. Okay. I thought you telling me we clean up my city car park. No, cause it
wasn't. What kind of threat this is?
Okay. So you ready for the confine the way down with me and do a little cleaning?
I might get that far. You never know. I might get there.
Okay.
Are you too far from me?
Oh, Queen, you live close up there?
Yes, yeah. I get put out the bottom bay. Not even the sweet bottom for a little while.
Right.
But I get put out. Mm-hmm. Not bad. Better get put out. I want the landlady somebody, mm-hmm. So I pack up.
I shame on you, though, to owe somebody money, though.
You don't want to buy the money?
No, I don't.
Mm-hmm. You damn you's a thief, then, because you only buy the, who don't want to buy money, Steve?
That's not true.
So you don't owe courts?
Mm-hmm. Nope.
Mannings?
Nope.
The cost?
Nah, never.
Plantations?
Never did it.
Care Hunt?
Nope.
Fogarty?
Nope.
You don't trust none of them?
Never did it.
You selling weed or something? No. You got me doing something on the hard end?
No, man. Mm-hmm. No. What happened, right, is that if I see something,
right,
I look at the price,
right,
and I save for it.
Are you selling for it?
Save.
You save for it?
Save for it. You see, you go look for a rainy day. Suppose now they said the more family now. I want the money now. They go,
right,
scratch my head and I say, yo, so, right, well, you know.
Yeah. So, wait a minute. So, let me say something now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
You going through town. I don't know the new fashion clothes, but let me say they used to got a brand name called Major Damage years ago.
I click suit.
Right? So you want a click suit.
Yeah.
You say in Bionic Man shop or someplace so now for $300.
Yeah.
So you save it for it.
Yeah.
And by the time you're going to buy it, that would have you.
Can't take that long.
So, but I tell you, when
you can't take that long.
When you wear major damage, a fella wear repair. So you wear major damage, and a fella wear repair.
I don't mind. I was still like the major damage.
But no,
PC Bruce, I contained it.
I contained it.
That's what I want, so that's what I buy.
My grandmother tell me, right, if you don't trust nobody, you don't know you.
Mm.
You understand? You've got to build a credit.
So just that how you owe the land.
Right.
You saw, she know you.
She know me now. For certain. So it would not be going back there. But you want people to stay here, listen.
You got to go to a paper trail and stuff like
that. You got to go to a paper trail so people will know you. So right, rather than going to court and buying the bed that costs $1,000 cash,
mm-hmm,
you can go in there, so get your name in the people book and still get it at cash price if you pay. I don't know how school is keep now. Mm-hmm. But it's got certain higher purchase places. Correct me if you're wrong, PC, bro. Uh-huh. They've got certain places that you pay off in 3 months, mm-hmm, you get it at cash price.
Cash price, right? Right. It's what happens.
So you build a little reputation of paying good.
Uh-huh.
Right.
So that when you go down to buy something like a big car,
mm-hmm,
yeah.
You know the whole cash, he got the new RAV4 or whatever it is that he's driving for.
He got a new one?
Man, yeah.
What?
What is the new car he's got?
Listen,
I tell him to write for it. Tell me to get up a Morza.
I don't know. He's a rare beer, John.
A new RAV4.
He is a rare beer, John. He who I'm sleeping by a piece of sponge, I got a bad new RAV4. I don't know how this operates. He got a piece of sponge, and the birds got it picked out. They got a clean sheet by the bed, it don't on the ground, but you know he want a RAV4. I don't know how school keeping with these people. So
wow.
When you walk by...
Cassie, wow.
When you walk,
the people, Cassie, I never expect that from you.
Huh? Yeah, it's a sport. I just don't know the names of them. When you see them going up the road, all is little wanting to be. I look at a blackbird flying backward. All is little one bird in me. I just can't tell who name who. But he got a new special breed that he got there, right?
Right, right.
So now I tell you, so when you go down to Simpson Motors or whoever it is you're going at to get the new special breed of car, they just want to get a credit report of you.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Right.
To see if you were custom playing people well or everything. Mm-hmm. Everything. But you said you was big 40 years old and you never trust nothing yet. Ooh. Chances are people can feel well. You might be selling a little vegetable matter all of a sudden. And you might not have to dig into your resources that much, you think. But if you hand them out, let me trust ramens. I just call it.
You do what?
Trust ramens.
Ramens?
Yeah.
I was from ramens on Chris Gill.
How would I know? I mean, you don't know music then. But I'm always coming here with this hypocritical sanctimonious big fashion foolishness. How would you know how much ramen costs? Kool-Aid? I have never drank that in my life yet. And I'm up there so tangerine and blue and all kind of got up and great Kool-Aid and all. Always a lot of poor, great foolishness. And you know, yeah, that poor, great with false talk and stupidness. President, you know how much Papa ramen is?
Nope. I don't know myself. I can't lie.
You just eat them.
I've never. Swear to God.
So you never, just eat lobster tail every day?
I never said I eat lobster tail every day.
But you get lobster!
But I just do that. I've never, ever eaten ramen before.
So so now how I tell you, you know that as well?
I never say that.
So man, I tell you when you say, when you eat shrimp?
Eclair biscuits.
Eclair biscuits?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
not sardine. It's not tuna. Sardine. Yeah, tuna.
You real poor, right? You know. So you don't eat sardine?
I don't mess with sardine.
You have never eaten sardine?
It was small. I had a choice. But when you get bigger, you got a choice, though. And like, I choose not to.
Mm. Okay, you're rich.
No, I'm not. No. That's not the case. That's not the case. It's just, I guess.
So wait a minute. You haven't eaten biscuit yet?
What?
You hear that there, son? PC Brooks, you ever had cut biscuit yet?
No.
we got me there now. Cut biscuit. What about you, Chris Gale?
The closest cut biscuit was stuffing.
Yeah? That's it.
No!
You mean stuffing?
No.
No, I said the closest.
I thought, why you know some people do stuffing
with biscuits? Yeah. Right? Yeah. So right. You don't mean that?
No.
So what do you mean then?
Cut biscuit. You cut your biscuit.
Biscuit
alright, you know what?
Not biscuit and rice, your big boy. Hey, idiot. Somebody cut biscuit and rice, your big clown.
Alright, hear me though, right? Huh? Explain it to us. Yeah. How do you cook biscuit?
You cook biscuit, how you cook sweet potato and yam and breakfast. Listen, you have stew food already?
Yes.
You know what stew food is?
Yes.
Where you got log grown food and different things and things.
Right.
You put the biscuit in there. When she's steaming down a little bit, when it's almost done, yeah, you don't put it in your water to boil from day one, when it's dry peas. Uh-huh. I know Chris Gale, when he's cooking dry peas, the rice is boiling dry peas one by one. He doesn't know how he's cooking already. Yeah. So that's a year's work. I'm talking about when you're cooking the stew food, I think, you take a packet, you clip the slit or whatever, and you chop on top of it as she's simmering. You know? So she would get some steam and thing, but she would still cook through, but she wouldn't be mushy. Mm.
Whoa.
You never had that there yet?
Never.
I had a fish broth, though. You do the broth and then dry biscuits and so you do, yeah. Oh. Right.
So you haven't eaten breadfruit or rice yet?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Yes.
I'm talking about breadfruit, cooking and rice.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So when you straight, I don't ask you straight.
What are you talking about, brother?
No, some people eat a lot of strange things.
So you don't like shrimp?
I eat shrimp. Mm-hmm. If I at somebody's place. Well, let me tell you, if you invite me at your little ting-ting, your bobsy, and you see shrimp there, then you all. Got when it left there.
It ain't happening.
It ain't happening again. You know what I'm saying, man?
I got it covered.
Not that I will overdo. Uh-huh. But I got some of the Christian people that ain't got the behavior at all. PC Brooms is one, and he know what I'm talking about. Right? You put down a pan of shrimp. Mm-hmm. It's shrimp or shrimps?
Shrimp.
Might say shrimp, yeah?
No, shrimp.
Shrimp is the small ones.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Shrimp is the small ones. Right. And shrimp is the big ones.
Big one, right.
Okay, that makes sense.
You covered now?
Right, you're covered.
Good.
You put up on shrimp there. Uh-huh. And you know people got little toothpicks and things. Some people take two shrimp, two fish cakes, mm-hmm. maybe a samosa. Mm-hmm. Right.
A samosa.
Same thing, one different. Mm-hmm. So you got a small plate, you pick up two little fried shrimp, uh-huh. two fish cakes. A samosa, maybe a little carrot stick, and you go along. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because you know, old school keeping other people got the taste. Not PC Browns.
He does eat everything?
He can take a plate and put 15 shrimp on it.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Is that true, PC Brown?
But you know what, come back, you know, me and want licorice, but you come back again, so you just take a
few. So you want licorice one time, and then you try to say?
One time.
You see, when you coming one back, time. You might be able to maneuver it.
Right.
You when you coming back, you walk and play. You're talking to somebody. Uh-huh. And when you're talking to somebody, you take up something else.
Any professional.
Uh-huh. That's a professional. Uh-huh. That's a professional
move. That's a professional
move.
Right.
But when you go on there, you take up 15 shrimp.
One time.
Or 35 fish plates. Uh-huh. That when you look like crush.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so
you're going on the move. You wouldn't know that.
So yeah, the matter way was telling you.
Funny professional.
Uh-huh. Right.
Right. So sometimes as I say, you've got to go up there, make sure your name in the people books uh-huh. and thing. Right. There's a certain country mm-hmm. who get I think about 16 downgrades in the last 2 years.
Mm-hmm. Sounds familiar.
Right, you don't know who it is. But a downgrade. After you get certain amount of downgrades, you keep on getting downgrades. You know what's happening is your credit is called a credit rating.
Can't borrow more.
No, you can't borrow more. The money can let you.
Right.
You will like to borrow.
Same thing.
Well, different. You will like to borrow.
Right.
But sometimes the fellow will let you. Mm-hmm. But he might name Larry the Knife. Mm-hmm.
Lefty.
Lefty, right. He money lefty.
Right.
And you know what's happened when you borrow lefty money, you can't pay back? Uh-huh. What's happened?
Yeah.
There's funny floating. Mm-hmm. So, so we at that stage now, that we're in this country. Actually, just done a recent downgrade too.
Yeah.
So this downgrade thing ain't going to end. Mm-hmm. It don't come to not. I hear last time we checked, they said that Barbados is around Greece and Venezuela, they kind of places.
Yeah.
That last time we heard, we credit rating almost on par with that kind of thing. You know, so I don't think we can bar from anybody right now.
Okay.
That's thing. Riri, where are you when we need you? But what making me laugh, right, is that I was reading up and doing some things, you know, to read and see what's going on. Mm-hmm. You know that this country is so small, right? Mm-hmm. Although it's a big country and things, that they got people that got full farms and potato farms and things bigger than Barbados.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Even the same cam oil bigger than Barbados.
You know what I'm saying?
Same cam oil, I said, Mark Aldersbury's place bigger than Barbados.
You know what I'm saying? A man in some part of the world, Australia and New Zealand and America, just open his back door and truck corn at folds.
Mm-hmm.
And what part he trade the corn bigger than Barbados?
Wow.
Yo,
it's real.
You picture that there, son.
It's real.
That a man got co-farms out there in Australia. And he co-farmed. For he to get the certain parts, he co-farmed, he's going to get a helicopter.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
He took up in the morning, evening time, he no get any at all, kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And we go a little backyard here, so. The kind of money we be looking for, what Donald Trump is doing, so I said, listen, I got the shop in this here, bring back this here, man. Oh, you can get it for India, then you know. $2.5 coming months of food, Mr. PC, bro. Many people know what's going on in here, so.
Mark Auto Spears. 4 locations to serve you, people. Bel Air, St. George. You can telephone Bel Air at 437-9819. Spooner's Hill, St. Michael, 425-9361. Salter, St. George, 228-6992. And Six Roads, 271-1297. Only top brand name parts for your vehicle. Mark Auto Spears, the number one Auto Spears in Barbados.
Well, you so too sweet. Yeah. Good evening, Queen. He is a Mojang. Cut biscuit does eat real sweet. I still look. Is it what I am? This is cut biscuit.
But if I never had it, I never had it.
I come by me later on.
No, I good.
Bring Crispy alone.
Nah.
I will fix it properly.
We good.
Fix it delicious.
Lydia and Johnson sitting there, salt biscuits too.
Yeah, it's called a salt biscuit.
Salt biscuit. Mm-hmm.
But does it go with a piece of pigtail or a piece of salt meat or anything? So it's worth it. Meanwhile, there's a lady also called Daniel Best. Mm-hmm. Right, he got a condition where he has difficulty swallowing and that kind of thing. You understand? And they're trying to get some work and medication and different things. We'll send you overseas probably and get certain things sorted out. And you understand that the medication thing he was taking damaged your liver and kidneys or something like that. Anyhow, the entertainers come together, all the John Root. John Root is champion in this cause. So they're going to have a cricket match, a fundraising cricket match that was supposed to be end of this month, but I think because of certain logistical issues, it has been pushed back to April the 2nd. Mm-hmm. April the 2nd at Windward Sports Club. Mm-hmm. Gabby's Windforce versus Placid by Volcanoes. Mm-hmm. And everybody who's anybody is playing on that cricket team. In those cricket matches. Mm-hmm. I don't think they're charging money at the door, but I think they'll be collecting a little donation. Mm-hmm. I will keep you posted as we go along. Mm-hmm. But just to let you know that they're trying to raise some money to help little Daniel Best. Mm-hmm. I was gonna get John Wright coming here so before the event too, so John could give me some more information. Cause you remember that little young girl named Kiana, Kiana Banfield or something like that. There, so that they had the first cricket match for, which Gabby's been forced one. So we're having a rematch. I know that Biggie Irie and Blunt, Mikey.
Biggie player cricket.
That's a Biggie player.
Yeah.
Biggie get run out twice. I ain't telling you lies. Biggie get run out twice with the same ball.
Yo.
And he didn't left the crease yet. So that's just to show what it was.
Okay, now what happened?
Biggie hit the ball, but for here's what to say, Vincent, and start running. And when the ball came up from St. Vincent, Biggie didn't even half here yet. And he get run out twice. So, anyhow, but I know Mr. Dale is playing Light Pipe and Sadis. You name it, everybody playing. And Queen Archibald Cox is playing. Let me remind y'all, last time Queen Archibald Cox played, who the boy there, Kurt Brown, get me out for naught. Mm-hmm. And that's how Kurt Brown get me out. Kurt Brown was balling so wide, right? I faced the first over for Kurt Brown. Kurt Brown was balling so wide that he hit a woman that was selling nuts by the side of the sidelines. While the balls were in the snow, come on, Kurt. Mm-hmm. And the ball that get me out, it was coming at the wicket so slow that I went to the bar.
Wow.
I really care about...
That what happened?
Right.
I understand.
It was so slow that I decided to go by the bar, drink two beers. Yeah. By the time he walked back, I see the ball hitting the stamps.
Wow.
That's the only ball that he got hit stamps in all his life. And it happened to be mine. But anyhow, I got the wicket of Admiral Nelson and the Mikey Gabby. I was on a hat trick.
Mm. Imagine Admiral playing cricket. Wow.
Admiral can play cricket. Not good. He's in the category of US City's cricket players right now. Who are here get beat real bad? They did a lot, but how much? 200 runs?
No.
What year, Simon? Mm-hmm. Oh, they get edge out there. You know, too bad. But anyhow, remember, little Daniel Best is a fundraising activity. Mm-hmm. It's at the Windward Cricket Grounds on April the 2nd. They get pushed back from March the 25th or 26th, something like that there. So we want everybody to come out and... I have this worthy cause. Also, there's another worthy cause going on the 25th of March. Mm-hmm. That is a Saturday.
Let me tell you.
Look at you, I'm not there.
March, who there? 21?
25th.
Yeah, March. It's a
Saturday.
Right, a Saturday. the Barbados. Mm-hmm. Let me get the correct titles here to make sure it's in. You know Barnard? You know who's Barnard?
Oh, Barnard, I think I'm a retired person or something.
No. Barbados National Organization for Disabled.
Oh,
right.
Okay.
It's hosting a fundraising walk on Saturday, March the 25th. Mm-hmm. Right? The walk starts at 6 a.m., starting at the Garrison Clock Tower and concluding at Queen's Park. Uh-huh. The road they will take in a number of organizations associated with the disabled community. Mm-hmm. Now, this is what they want you to do, right? Mm-hmm. They want you to walk a mile in their shoes. In other words, when you come on this walk, they want you to assume that you are disabled like them. Mm-hmm. So you can either walk with crutches, you can either walk blindfolded, you could be in a wheelchair. Mm-hmm. However, but they want you to see what they just have to go through on a daily basis. Okay. You follow me, PC, bro? Everybody's going too fast for you because you're an African snail, you know. Everybody's going too slow for you. I can turn back and catch up you. Right. So they want people and companies, you've got these crew groups or work groups or whatever to turn up. And they want you to register. Now, registration is $20 Barbados for persons over 12 years of age and $10 for people under 12, right? And when you get there, we get a gift pack, receive a gift pack or whatever. Mm-hmm. And registration closes on the 24th, which is Friday evening, right? If you want more information, you can call 248-0656 or you can message me, the Queen, at 231-4259, 231-4259. But it's all in aid of a worthy cause. They're trying to raise some funds and different things. Mm-hmm. So it is Barnard.
Barnard.
Who Barnard mean again, PC, bro?
Barbados, Nod. Barbados
National Organization for the Disabled.
Right, got it.
Barnard is hosting their fundraising walk on Saturday, March the 25th. It starts at 6 o'clock at the Garrison Clock Tower. Right. And as I say, they want you to walk a mile in their shoes. So you can either come, you can be blindfolded, you can walk with crutches, you can get wheelchairs to thing, but they want you to see what they just have to go through
every day
on a daily basis. All right.
Somebody asked me on WhatsApp if there's a bank account for the youngster.
Mm-hmm. I think, yes, there's a bank account. John Roy, if you're listening, or somebody, John Roy, message me with if you've got the bank account information there so that people could donate the little dividend towards the youngster, right? Because, you know, every little bit counts. Some people may not be able to get the cricket match, but some people may be able to put a little taller in the tail. Don't give it to me. Don't put the money in my eye, because my light bill is...
Are you all right?
My light bill is facing soft touch right now.
Are you all right?
Right, and it all right. So don't throw the money in my eye.
Rick Wayne, this morning, something strange happened to you this morning, huh? What? Between 8:30 and 9. I just trying to check. Something strange happened to me this morning.
You bid?
No, not out of here.
That was after 9 o'clock.
No, yeah, I had one of them supernatural experiences in that canyon this morning.
Yeah.
So I just wonder if you see anything happen to you.
No, no.
You had nothing strange happen to you?
Between 8:30 and 9 o'clock?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Nope. No.
I'm gonna tell what happened to me, man. It's still got me offset though, you know.
You had a body movement, what happened? Yeah. But you trying to find out, you got me Friday.
I'm gonna tell you, hush your mouth, little talk.
Okay, go along.
Listen, I checking for my little partner there across the road saw this morning, right? No, listen to the program, I think. So I listen to you, are you people still getting heat, but you know, we get heat in the studio here, there.
Uh-huh.
So somebody calling you some more heat and thing, right? But then though, afterwards I hear the man talking about Barbara's got a lot of Mongols. And you know what? I just drive up on the road. You know how about that same exact
A mongoose run
pregnant mongoose run straight across in front of my car.
But that's
not me in trouble.
Listen, a mongoose cannot be pregnant.
Yes.
It has to be a woman goose.
Oh, sorry.
Right.
You must be right then. You must be right. That's what happened for two. Listen, I have you in beer trouble.
Wow.
So I figure thoughts of the man. He called. I feel like I'll be a man on speed though.
But that could happen.
But that for me the same thing. Right. I feel that will happen. It's something like that, you know.
So a woman goose run across in front of you there?
In front of my car, yeah.
Wow. You kill it?
No. No, you can't kill it. That would have me in trouble because you can't kill him.
So you're not pregnant. You swear as well.
I swear off, to protect me.
You're hitting the pothole on there?
None so.
You sure?
I good.
All right.
I good.
Yeah, you good.
I got me a little shake up and thing, but.
So then. So you figured out, so I put a curse by you know?
No, he call it Obey, man. He call it Obey, man, for me. I put a curse by me. So, but instead, he said, where a mongoose for him?
A woman goose. Yeah.
Waffle again.
Right, so a woman goose ran. So, man, if you had a chance, a choice of hitting the woman goose, cause it's a man can't be pregnant.
No, you can't hit none that pregnant. Uh-huh. So, even when you was a sharpshooter, when you was learning the training thing, you know that's here too, thing, Indian.
Mm-hmm.
When you learning this, the targets would be like, man, a criminal.
Right,
and then they stroke like a pregnant woman or a woman with a baby or a problem.
To see how
fast
her reflexes are.
Exactly, right. Right,
yeah.
Right. So it's just be checking.
Yeah.
So you can't hit none of them targets, right? So that's when you got anything that pregnant, you just try and shift it.
So if you had a choice, hitting you care.
I'll go hit the care.
I'll hit it on pregnant, a woman goes.
I'll go hit the care for you.
Wow.
Not how good my reflexes, I guess.
That's not gonna sound good at all.
I know the parts that mark on the spreadsheet, right? The parts that mark on the spreadsheet.
It don't sound good.
The parts that mark on the spreadsheet, but the body parts are a little expensive. I'm talking about a hospital.
I can't understand. You can hit a car.
Because let me tell you, if I got a choice between hitting my car on a pole and hitting a pregnant woman goose.
It gone.
Near, oh my God. Let your family pick up funeral hymns, because that is the end of that there, so.
I called my good friend Norva there at the RSPCA. I contact you, and he read chapter and verse of the Animal Cruelty Acts to you.
And it's not Animal Cruelty, so I said, wait, talk about your own mongoose?
Yes.
Wow.
I said, wait, talk about your
own. You can't hit a pregnant mongoose. I agree,
wait a minute. I said, wait, talk about your own. Risking myself over pregnant mongoose.
The parts are marked on the spirit to you.
Yeah, the parts are. But how much hate mark on the spirit to you?
Your body parts. What about your body parts?
No, I ain't all got.
You got a thing.
How I can live myself killing a mongoose.
What is the price of a
son? How you know it's pregnant?
Yeah, you can see, you know this ain't pregnant.
You see it real fast.
Yeah. No, it's very slow, so I see everything.
Okay.
I see everything. It's very slow.
All right. What is the price of a size 10 human head that marks on the spirit? Let me know about that there, so I can call them. If I don't, they got them in my size.
I will check with Mark. I know. I see prices in front of me.
Call me tell you something. Anything that ran across my car, if it's a human being, I will swerve.
Uh-huh.
Dog, cat, horse, I don't care about it. I am not rushing off my car trying to save the pregnant chicken. That somebody can cut off your neck next week and say that Kentucky for chicken anyhow. So he might as well die there one, huh, man?
Let's turn it up.
Really feel if a duck, let me tell you something, I'm going to eat popcorn the reason I do, because let me tell you, if a duck ran across in front of my car, and I hit it, I get up and peep and see who's peeping at me first and jump in the back of my trunk. End of conversation. He came up and said, good luck here, Rosie Morning. You get all right. You worry about my goose. I'm glad I saw him put the little curse by you, though, because he's a nuisance. Good evening to my good friend Penny, locked on to the marks on the space, of course. My good friend Avril. Good evening, Queen. Tell them that is where a lot of these young men have to drink so much mixed stuff. I mean, she mean y'all.
What?
Ask Indian and Chris Dale if they ever had fish head soup.
Mm-hmm. Not my thing.
Yeah? You look, oh, my man, sport. I think my boy got two fish head in the freezer there now. I got taught it on this weekend, boy.
Hey, bro.
You got fish head from Ula Tennis Sardine? Well, you know about the fish? That's Sardine head? You boy?
Nah, the dolphin, man.
Chris Dale got him?
Yeah, I know pretty good.
So, Indian.
He means you running.
You don't
the man so smart in my mind, I left him by myself. he might use those stories.
I left you here, but you said.
But it's heat here, we can't say.
Wait a minute. So, Indian.
Yeah.
You never have a little fish head broth?
Nah. Nope. It just ain't my thing.
Chicken foot soup, though.
Nah. Ain't my thing.
You gotta ask if he's eating the just now, boy.
No, me say you don't eat. I tell you. So, man. Yeah, they give you a little star, but don't anyhow.
Right,
so
right.
You expect that to you. So, you're eating the fish head soup?
Nope.
The chicken stabber soup?
Nope.
No goat head soup?
Who? No.
You eat that pigfoot soup, though?
Nah.
You eat chicken soup?
Yeah, like a pie.
Yard fowl chicken?
No.
So you're eating a yard fowl chicken, though?
No.
It's going to come out.
For what? The yard fowl chicken, the meat is pretty tough. So
yeah,
it's
hard.
It's hard. It's hard.
It's harder than the regular one.
But the regular chicken, so, mm-hmm. And if you choose to eat that, man, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, listen, the thing about yard fowl chicken, right, is that it is organic. Mm-hmm. That meat is raised by natural stuff. Mm-hmm. Probably don't eat
it's getting the race or the part and not going to eat it.
Right.
You left back, that's what chicken is eating.
But we will have back and eat yourself, so that's called. If you don't eat chicken and you don't want them all, you straight yard, easy then.
Easy.
Right.
Easy yourself. You eat eggs, you eat the little children, so that's when you're too hungry.
Right.
You eat bush.
Anything.
If you go to a cockroach party in your yard, he's going to cockroach party. Uh-huh. Like, enjoy yourself. Mm. So you don't eat that fella neither?
Nope.
Okay, all right.
You can see how school giving me, you. Anyway, you on it's how school giving. Tell me something, let me ask you a malicious question here, because when I ask me a malicious question, you know what I mean? Malicious, so he's going to get malicious answers. Uh-huh. How school is keeping these kind of situations? You agree to rent an apartment. Me and you, PC Bros, we going forward to rent this apartment as roommates.
All right, for everybody just tune in, right? This is just a hypothetical question. I
read the PSP.
Good, exactly. We cleared up. Good, all right. Continue, you know.
You know, man, eat chicken and chili bones on his head, you know, careful. I don't like that kind of lifestyle.
Uh-huh, anyway,
so we going forward. Uh-huh. Me and you going forward to rent this place, roommates. What, you got one room, I got one room.
Uh-huh, okay.
Right. And let me say the rent, the body paying, the person who rent him in the place, say, okay, electricity free in the rent, but we're all school keeping up with water. Mm-hmm. We don't got to put it, we don't got to deal with the water with itself, because you don't want people overdoing the water thing. You can't deal with that years ago.
Right.
Okay, so the rent roughly is $1,000. And the water, let me say the water bill has come to roughly $50 when the month coming. Roughly around that region. So we split it up. You pay $500 in rent. I pay $500. You give me $25. We pay you $25. We pay the water bill. And things going on good.
Right.
You bring in a girlfriend now.
You got to pay more money there.
Your girlfriend and live there. But she just spend, let me say, 4 days in the week sleeping over. They get a bed for the morning.
Oh, also bed how you live there, man. So you got country with our water and rent too, because she's sleeping.
So give me the bread. I don't know how the rent, because I tell the girl, let me tell you something. This whole school going to go and keep now. Every paying $500, I used to pay $500. This rent is got divided in three now.
Exactly.
Because that's what he's saying. Mm-hmm. But she is saying that the body saying that their partner is going to come, not every day, but you know. Up on the Sunday, the lab will spend a little length time. They'll come over upon the night and get things happen. Probably be able to go work sometimes. Not every single day. But on Sundays, by the Sunday, we'll come down and eat food and everything.
Now, they're just testing waters before the moving. So you got to put a stop to that there. So you got to tell us, no.
So how the breakdown will come now? Because technically speaking, that body ain't got room for themselves. You got your own room.
Right.
He got his own room. But the girlfriend is come over or whatever. So the money split in three for the rent?
I wouldn't do it three. OG. He paying $500. He got you an extra $250, I think.
Okay. Hey, what you listening to, Marvin? This is. They see Roman saying. So you cutting your money in half?
Yeah. You got my money got to get cut.
So you want to put in $250?
I'm going to pay $250, right? I think
that's what I'm missing. And the other $750? That's
half. Let me see. Yeah. I'll pay a tree, though. I'll pay a tree. I'll pay a tree.
Marv, you listening?
I'll pay a tree.
Arrange that you will pay a tree.
Uh-huh.
Because she said she ain't paying more money. She done with that.
She got to pay less now, man.
No, what I'm saying, they should be saying, you go work it out. Mm-hmm. It's one way for you to tell me, man, the body don't live here. Mm-hmm. If you want me to stop them from coming here, then?
Mm. They ain't gonna stop them from coming here.
But if they come in,
you gotta contribute to the cause.
But suppose they start to withdraw themselves, they only come in once a week. They still gotta contribute to the cause.
Mm. But no, you gotta say up front what you're doing. If she already there coming there 4 days a week, that is the majority of the week she coming there already.
Right.
So good. She established that idea. So let that be the one and be.
I imagine she know.
The rest of she know. Tell right.
You listen to that, you know what I mean? PC Brooms is saying that since the person is bringing their partner there, because the partner don't have to be living there wholly and solely, the constitution, the majority of the week, that person then, that your bill should be reduced by about, let me say, a quarter or thereabout, and she partner should pick up the other total. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Don't message me again, ask me foolishness. You're going to tell them so, or lock off, or say, you're paying, and when the woman comes, everybody will deal with it.
Right.
And it will go to their head. Good evening.
And that's the other thing, too, you know. Everybody that rented the place now, come and see that body there at the place now, the majestic already rain.
It's true. It happens. Because I guess if you rent for two people,
exactly,
and then you bring in a third person, mm-hmm. then they may want to charge more.
Correct.
It happens.
But you know, they got people in Barbados that's come at you, right? Mm-hmm. Rent a house from you. Or let me say you're renting a good three-bedroom house in Barbados. You're renting the house, let me say $1,500 a month crime. Mm-hmm. Got three bedrooms. Mm-hmm. Somebody know will come mm-hmm. at you, mm-hmm. rent the house, mm-hmm. and then rent who your bedrooms are on. That's what people are doing in Barbados. I want you know people to do that.
They're moving real crafty, boy. They're moving smart.
Man, no, they got people to do that. They got people.
Yeah.
Seriously. Mm-hmm. They got people that scam by you. Mm-hmm. Rent your house. They got three or four bedrooms. Mm-hmm. And then they got some fellas here from Georgetown and Burmese and all kind of things.
Linden.
And from Portville and Jamaica and all kind of places. But here, so, you know, they're doing the work and things.
Yeah, yeah.
But they're looking for somewhere to live, and they want a big extravagant apartment. They just want a little room
to put on the head
that they can pay a little $300 when the week comes. Mm-hmm. So you got a man there, so I know, from Georgetown, in your house that you rent a man or a woman to, and this fella here, let me call it Ron Passard. Mm-hmm. Good evening to you, Ron Passard. From Georgetown, though, he in your house, in one room. Mm-hmm. And he paid the BCA $250 a week.
Uh-huh.
By four, mm-hmm. that's $1,000.
Right.
So that body got three rooms in your house, no, right? Two other rooms in your house, right? No, you know. So they're getting $3,000.
Sometimes the garage, too.
Party garage. Party garage. Uh-huh. So that body making, they're getting $3,000, mm-hmm. and at the end of the month, they're coming to give you $1,500. Mm-hmm. And it happening not only with houses, mm-hmm. it happening with the government, too.
Yeah, what are they
doing? You know the little houses and things that people got renting for NHC and things and all kind of thing?
Mm-hmm.
That is only going to pay $10 a week and all kind of thing?
Yeah.
They got people that renting up rooms in them to ramp us all, and they people. Shh. You understand? So when they're paying the government at least $60 a week or a month or whatever,
mm-hmm.
then charging the fella $100
mm-hmm.
for a room in there. So they're making a piece of change. And not only that, they're going to pass that there now. They got people who got stalls
mm-hmm.
in government markets and things.
Uh-huh.
You understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Now, when government got set up a market or anything, so and they rent you a little space, they try to help the poor man.
Uh-huh.
You know, so you can come and sell a little bread and fish, mm-hmm. a little juicy and sweet drink and things, and right. two little beers or whatever the case may be. Mm-hmm. So they think they'll be at the place that you will rent a small street store for.
Right.
Yeah, but only go up here a little $100 a month. Or uh-huh. It's just something to make sure that fellas don't wreck in people's houses. You got some place to think. But you got some people who will come to the government, get a little stall or something or the other, mm-hmm. pay the government at least $100 a month,
uh-huh.
and turn around and rent it to somebody for $800 and $1,000 a month. Because you know that if you got a thriving little business,
yeah.
and you selling beers and you got little karaoke and you got different mm-hmm. things going on, mm-hmm. you can make back you $800 easily.
Mm-hmm. Comfortable.
So you got people who defrauding the system.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? They're tricky.
Mm-hmm. So they're going to be checking for these things.
Yeah, but you can't start telling me that Johnny working for me.
Yeah,
I rent a place for you. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
you come and see Indian in there.
You can't. For the bits.
But so the bits of people that ain't going
to look at the alert. Throwing devil out.
There's some people.
Look.
The main ones are celebrating some people who got the tea.
We ain't got none here, Christy. I'm sorry.
Yo, Rasta, man. You hear that? Soda bits for people who ain't got the teeth.
Mm. We got the teeth.
You got brother?
That's for white people.
You got teeth that back up.
You got extra. Good evening, Queen and Subjects. I went into Mark 6 Road location to get my parts, list, quotation, everything on 800 and a bonus. Attendant was so helpful in replacing even my brake light bulb.
Whoa.
Yeah. Yeah, here we go.
Good service.
Yeah, good service.
That's yeah. Good all the time. Hey, man, I got air freshener too, man. I had a nice one at the end there. Ugh, man. It smell real good. You got to buy that there, Chris Gill, if you care.
Black ice.
Not black ice, just ice. Just ice.
Black and raining and white.
Yeah.
Was that just what you're fresh?
You're fresh, I'm a call the spirit, man. Real nice, man.
You put some on your armpit or
all over me, man. Oh,
it works, eh? When I say you smell fresh enough, it walking. Can you shout out Alicia Ramchandani and Ria Umchandani?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right.
All right. All right, shout out to Kareem, who's at work there at the Treasury. Good evening to you.
Don't forget, people, Barnard, their walk is coming off shortly. Right. Registration is $20 for persons over 12. And on the 12, I think it's only $10. Mm-hmm. They're starting from the clock tower there. So, you know, part of that is it moved by Garrison.
Oh, right, Garrison, yeah.
Right, 6 o'clock. Give them a call and get things sorted out. They're trying to raise some funds. You know how it does be. Mm-hmm. It's called Walk a Mile in My Shoe.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? They want you to come and be blindfolded, walk with crutches, be in a wheelchair, anything like that there. So if you want more information, message me between 231-4259, 231-4259, and I will give you some more information because we want this here to be big. Tell me, Queen, them fellas in there with you real pop down. They don't, but that's what the boys say here. They don't know good old grandma the food. You know what I'm saying? Grandmother used to cook with a lot of good things, ginger and turmeric. You know what turmeric is?
Yes.
You ever had it?
Yes.
I thought you said no. Okay, all right, good.
But don't
forget. It's not a case of being popped down. It's a case of how Chris Gill likes soda bits. I prefer Eclair biscuits.
By the way, we talking about eating goat head soup and belly soup and
all that. Chris, you ever had goat head soup before?
Nope.
Okay, then.
You ever had fish head soup, Chris Gill?
Going and coming.
You hear that? Yeah, no.
Oh, that's one. One. That's one.
Use it sawfish?
Nah, I don't mess with that.
Yeah. What you really eat on?
Sawfish.
Use it sawfish and rice on it, you know what I'm
saying? Correct.
That's
a nice
cuckoo.
I don't mess with cuckoo, period. There's a reason why, you know. There's a reason why, you know.
Is that you want last woman that you had cooked cuckoo at the barber's planet ring?
Nah, what happened is very. No, I'll be honest with you. When I was a young one, I was about 4 or 5 years old. And my mother came with the next one, they better keep me. So the woman cooked cuckoo.
Yeah.
And I eat it. I should not have eaten the cuckoo. You understand? Because.
You don't eat cuckoo when you want?
You understand? So when my mother get up for a turn on, I said, oh, well, yeah, I eat a little cuckoo. You see, friend, brother, I get washed off in legs, but I never eat cuckoo sex. I done with that, friend. No, hungry enough, brother.
Man, if you're hungry, parents, that's the thing about parents, being a parent, I don't understand. Being a parent is...
But then when you come out late Christmas, what happened now?
Yeah, come out late Christmas. Yeah, just get torn in or poison.
What happened
then? What are you talking about?
Being a parent, right? Being a parent, that's got little children. I know how little children does be. And then they tell little children, no, where you get supermarket, you don't ask me for nothing. You hear what I tell you? Or when you go to this fair, you don't ask me for nothing. Eat your food before you left home. Or when you get me, Mr. Thomas, you don't go ask Mr. Thomas for no ice water and all that. So you hear what I tell you? Because they feel like you should be asking for nothing. Look at there. If you ain't getting little boy nothing to eat, you go out in town. You left home since 9 o'clock in the morning. Get little boy a cup of tea. All right. School keep a certain many guts. You all right for an hour or two. 3 o'clock, you are coming home from town, yeah? Because you in at Moses and Kerpalani's and everybody's looking at curtains. Okay, no problem with that there.
Right.
The woman put on little macaroni and corned beef and said, George, you ain't letting us here. Okay, good. What did that boy say, no?
You better try to hold up to your mother again.
Hold up, man.
You better try to hold out.
Hold up,
PC Bruce? You better hold out, boy. What happened now, PC Bruce? They couldn't seem to make you a better man now. Because you know about hard times. Holding out.
Correct.
You gotta hold up, but you see, Bobby, Queen, you let Chris.
So I just started, I let my eyes roll back in the back of my head, and my mouth started to take out.
You gotta hold out, boy.
I am not holding out, I'm really hungry, man.
You gotta hold out.
You make it
when you're small, PC Brooms, you gotta hold out. With some parents, you gotta hold out. You got to, in the 2 years, boy, you have to hold out.
But what hold out, what? I know you get nervous.
I want to know.
My mother left me. First of all, I asked you for something. If you don't ask, if you go off me, you go out and talk a whole day. Left me at Miss Joseph. You go out and don't say 9 o'clock. You ain't everybody's, the cost of money and all, because the place looking for Christmas curtains.
Right.
You will come back 3 o'clock, come and go on. That's when you're 8 hours already. That's a day's work. Now I see the people there, so staring right at cocoa and all kind of things.
But they're growing away.
I can smell pork bacon or chicken stewing.
Right.
Or, you know when chicken frying heard the song? I smell sweet.
You see, bro, you were sellout, though. You were too shit. They you brain. You move like you were sellout.
Yeah, something like that
would do. Right, you want me to be a French, you think? And the scent permeated the atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
You was 5 or 6 years old.
Oh, hello. I care what you say.
You see the woman pull a macaroni pie on the oven.
I care what you say.
And the steam rising.
Hold out.
And she make a little plate there so for wash the children, a little piece of macaroni pie.
And move like the red Indian. And hold a fast.
And the little boy come and sit down next to you.
And hold a fast.
And then she asks you, Indian?
Nope.
You want some of this here?
And good.
Let's say no, then.
And good.
Not me.
What about you, Chris Gill?
What
happened? You can eat it?
What's that?
You mother tell you don't eat name from nobody.
Uh-huh.
She left you with your next door neighbor.
Uh-huh.
Go on town the whole day.
Go on town now from morning to let me say evening time. Mm-hmm. You understand? In next door neighbor, so I cut some macaroni pie and whatever, chicken, fried chicken, whatever.
Morning time, Sunday morning, okay, 8 o'clock, you go on church. The man is there, so preaching the whole day. When you take it down, he said, no, turn the verse. He clicks the answer this verse 7 through 19. He go back again. When you take it down, he go on to Psalms 13:47. When you take it down, he talk about 2 Samuel. I don't even know how the first Samuel. He talk about 2 Samuel. Okay. Then you know, he talk about Thessalonians 14:12 and all kind of thing. When you check the time now, 1 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Are you mad at your grandma? And there's so beating tambourine and symbol. Oh, you there hungry still?
Nah, he's gonna walk with snacks in
you
church.
Hungry and still?
What was that snacks? Yeah,
he's gonna walk with snacks at church. Yeah.
Somebody offer you a toffee. Are you about to see the body hand you a toffee and look at you cruel?
My brother, it was even a slap on your hand. You look alone. You look alone. It's like, see, it's a living color, brother. You want that toffee?
Listen, I know a girl, I know this girl very well. She sent church the little child with grandmother. She ain't got you know, but she sent the children to the grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The call she from church and tell she that the little boy break his hand. How he break his hand? I don't know how to actually treat going in church or whatever. But during the service, the little children must get hungry.
Mm-hmm.
And then looks like looking back his.
Right.
Claim a big tree.
Mm-hmm.
And break his hand, follow and break his hand.
Yeah.
You understand?
Right.
If she didn't tell your grandmother, listen, he going to church for 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock. When you see 11 o'clock, I said, the school done, get my children back here.
Mm-hmm.
You think that what happened? I speak to room, say, you can't church little children. You should pack a little snack.
Yeah, what was
that? A little snack.
Yeah. You got to remember that children and big people.
It's true.
And it's true, if you mother to go over, the woman, off you mother, cocoa, you mother, he's like, cocoa, don't say it very well.
Oh, boy, don't forget, people, clean bim. Clean Bin presents Clean Up Your Own Backyard this Saturday at the Massey Car Park in Warrens. They'll be featuring presentations on community recycling and green waste management. Let me get some more information for that idea now.
Look, somebody got here. I will have to starve till the money get back. What I tell you?
We got enough people up there like that there for sure.
We grew up now. We ain't getting there for the money, brother. Eat or drink from nobody.
That's real, boy. Clean Bin. Clean Bin.
Clean Bin.
Clean Bin, man. The cleanup starts from 6 a.m. until 8 a.m. and from 8 till 12 p.m. in the Massey car park. There'll be lectures on waste management, recycling, health checks, and other activities and giveaways.
Mm-hmm.
So come on down to the Massey car park this Saturday, 6 a.m.
Right.
For Clean Bin. Clean up your own backyard.
Good evening, Queen. Sending shout out to the Back to School Fundraising Committee for the St. James Secondary Old Scholars. This is coming from Catherine.
Mm-hmm.
This boy said, my mother used to pack my own food. So when she put it to me at somebody, she was saying, what happens? So,
but you know, sometimes everybody was not that ready to pack, you know, a lunch bag or whatever. Back in the days, it wasn't like that. It wasn't like pack a lunch box.
I used to carry lunch, but every day. I made 12 eating my lunch.
Yeah, where, sure. Chris Gill?
In the neighbor.
Were you neighbor?
What's all lunchbox you had, Chris Gill?
He had a Powerpuff Girl lunchbox.
I had a Zorro lunchbox. You had big metal ones?
He had a Powerpuff Girl lunchbox.
I had a Bush Boy bike.
But that's a lunchbox, though. Rick reminds me.
Mm-hmm.
I know a man that he won't put it out.
Mm-hmm.
And he please call a man, call my friend Chessie, tell Chessie, because Chessie got a big flat big truck.
Yeah, true.
Chessie, the woman put him out, so why don't you come and collect me?
Mm.
Chessie turned into a big flat big truck, mm. And the man come up with two bad boy bags that he had. or two on the wrist coming up to the hall of the law. Kind of I know it does be mine. I know some parents be very, very strict.
Very strict.
And you ain't supposed to eat nothing from nobody.
Mm-hmm.
And you know you ain't to drink nothing from nobody. Right. If you're going to die. You know, the saying of fear, mm-hmm. Maybe you're going to be fair to feed you before you left
mm-hmm.
home.
Mm-hmm.
So that when you get there, you ain't even got no money to buy hot dogs, or you got the children eating hot dogs mm-hmm. and everything. And I don't know how you do that all.
Yeah.
You tell the child, eat your food before you left here.
Mm-hmm.
So you try to put down a big bowl of bread for cocoa that you're going to stir concrete. You just get each other a ticket to go in. And
I would be that strict, like, you know what I mean? You gotta get little spending money to buy little snacks and stuff. Little children you buy.
But that's why children gotta do this thing.
And the problem with you getting your child some money to buy a hot dog or cut a candy or getting lucky dip, that's cool.
Yeah.
But just don't eat from the body.
But you overplay with your friend.
That's all.
You next door playing with your little friend, and your little friend at the table eating macaroni pie. Fried chicken. Mm-hmm. No, back in the day,
uh-huh.
when I was a legend growing up, they got certain things you didn't used to get that regular.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your mother, and she small ways, or grandmother, as the case may be, the food, the meat pan, the food used to consist of things like corned beef most of the time. Corned beef, probably little salt fish. Salt fish was cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Little salt fish.
Mm-hmm.
But on the Sunday, you would get like real meat. You would get like chicken.
Right.
Or piece of pork or whatever. During the week, you had you have eaten sardines and rice. You used to get sardine gravy.
Mm-hmm.
People used to make sardine gravy and everything.
Mm-hmm.
That we used to get. Now, picture this here. You over at your friend's house in the middle of the week, a chicken friend.
Mm-hmm.
You got chicken friend. You the custom general for chicken at all. The only thing you get piece of chicken is for the Sunday.
Yeah, we can.
It's by the Sunday.
Mm.
So, Sunday, you got to wait to get a piece of baked chicken or whatever.
Right.
Wednesday, you get fried chicken and macaroni pie.
Mm-hmm.
And you at somebody's house. And I ask if you want some.
Hold out.
I used to know.
Hold out.
Oh, okay. May the Lord bless you.
Hashtag, hold out.
Hold out.
That's it. Hashtag, hold out.
Anyhow, people.
What about you, Corey Marshall? You ever, you might have ever put you some place before, but your next one neighbor or somebody keep you, and anybody cook, and you eat it? You lit, Chris.
You hear that, yes, or
no? He play water tart. He lit, Chris.
Okay. He get free water today. Okay. Any old people that's not coming evening, we got to leave inside here. They got people here that got, they got over half an hour or something. So you know, school has got to keep them when things happening.
Yeah,
so,
you know he? Never seen before?
Who's what?
You wear a blue shirt? Yeah.
Yeah, he's look familiar.
Yeah. You ever watched SpongeBob SquarePants before?
Which one he is?
Squidward.
Okay. I didn't know. You're tall, though. You don't look so tall on TV. Anyhow, nobody soon uses it here. Remember, people, when you're buying car parts this weekend,
where
to go, PC, bro?
Mark Auto Spares.
Yeah.
Four locations. Remember, Salter, St. George,
uh-huh.
Bel Air, St. George, Six Roads, all the way in St. Florida,
mm-hmm.
and... Okay, guys, try this people. Darrison Plaza in Spooner Hill.
Right.
It's that time, so we got to go, people. Enjoy. I'm gone.
All right, those 2 half hours were brought you with the compliments of Mark's Auto Spares.